If there's one thing that Mr. Men and Little Misses enjoy, it's sleep. Whether it's a restful night of slumber or a quick nap in the garden, the people of Dillydale know that the secret to staying healthy is to get plenty of rest. Which is why everyone agrees Mr. Lazy must be the healthiest fellow in town.
Hello, I'm Mr. Small, and here at Dillydale Mattress, we don't need a crystal ball to tell you what kind of mattress you need. Because we have something better! Mr. Nosey, the Mattress Wizard!
That's right, Mr. Small. I guarantee that I can tell you exactly what you need in a new mattress.
Let's hear from some of our satisfied customers, Mattress Wizard.
The Mattress Wizard understands his customers. He picked the perfect bed for me. Best of all, I never have to make it. Thanks, Mattress Wizard.
He chose this bed for me because it's on the floor, so nothing can hide underneath it. Thanks, Mattress Wizard.
Excellent choices all, oh Mattress Wizard. It's a gift, so come on down to Dillydale Mattress and see the wizard.
Any idea what kind of mattress I should get?
You bet, Miss Daredevil.
Take your Mattress Wizard!
I am really excited about this concert, aren't you, Mr. Rude? Love music, all kinds of music, even birds chirping, which I'm not sure is even considered music.
Miss Chatterbox, I came out here to hear a concert, not your non-stop talk.
Oh, sorry. Right. We're here to listen to Mr. Pernickety play piano. It's his very first time playing on stage.
You mean he is a beginner?
Oh, yes. But I'm sure he's a very good beginner. He's good at everything and very organized. I think you have to be organized to play piano. Oh, here he comes.
Not until I hear if he is any good.
I wonder if Mr. Benickety's nervous playing in front of all these people. I know I'd be breaking into a cold sweat. I wonder why they call it a cold sweat when sweating usually means you're really hot. I can't believe Mr. Grumpy heard me. I was practically whispering. The sound in the tall must really carry. Wonder why that is.
Do you know anything about that, Mr. Rude? Mr. Rude?
Oh, no, Mr. Rude. You have to wake up. You can't sleep at someone's concert. That's bad manners.
So is talking during a concert. Now pipe down.
Sunshine, help me wake up Mr. Rude before Mr. Pernickety sees and thinks that this concert is boring.
Wake up, Mr. Rude!
Picnics are for idiots!
What's the matter, Miss Chatterbox?
Mr. Rude is talking in his sleep, which is making Mr. Pernickety make mistakes, which we know he usually doesn't do because, well, he's Mr. Pernickety!
There's nothing I hate more than dancing clowns.
Oh, we have to wake him up.
Please, let me. Wake up, Mr. Reeves. It's tickle time.
Get away, you octopus. Do you want to borrow my kazoo?
No, I don't think so.
How about my banjo?
No.
Horn in a can?
That might work, but will it disturb Mr. Pernickety?
Oh, he won't even notice.
Bravo!
Bravo, Mr. Pernickety! Nickety. That was the most restful concert I have ever attended. I feel like a new man. What's his problem?
It's a long story. Has anyone ever told you that you talk in your sleep?
I have no idea what you mean.
I'm telling you, I'm not tired. There's no way I could sleep a wink. I really wasn't snoozing. I close my eyes whenever I think. I'm really not that sleepy. I could stay up till dawn. You're wrong, I wasn't nodding off. That was a sigh and not a yawn.
Who needs sleep?
Not me.
Just stay awake all night.
Sleep is cheap.
Who needs sleep?
I don't need it.
Exercise your eyes.
I will.
Who needs sleep?
I don't.
It's really such a bore. Don't tell me that I'm drowning.
That was a snort and not a snore.
Sounds like a monster.
A hideous, hungry monster in a very bad mood. We better leave town.
Hey, Mr. Davis, what's that noise?
I hate to say it, Mr. Messy, but I think it's a monster.
Look, I'm telling you, Mr. Grumpy, whatever it is, it's big.
Not to mention annoying, I'm trying to sleep. Someone needs to go in there and tell it to be quiet.
Sheesh.
Don't look at me.
I'm on my way out of town.
What he said.
Hey, I'll do it. I'm not afraid. Oh.
I am. Call me when it's over.
Stay where you are, Mr. Nervous. No monster's going to drive us from our homes.
Maybe not you from your home.
Oh.
I don't know if you should go in there, Mr. Strong.
Don't try and talk him out of it. I want to get some sleep.
Go ahead. Do your thing.
It's taking too long.
I never said goodbye.
We can't let Mr. Strong go in there alone.
Oh, yes, we can. Watch.
We're right behind you, Mr. Strong.
Can we go now? I've seen enough.
We haven't seen anything yet.
Exactly.
I wish I could say it was nice knowing you.
It's coming from it there.
No.
Okay, everybody stand back.
Nice work, Mr. Strong. I could use a few holes like this over at my house.
I'll come round tomorrow.
You've got yourself a deal.
Will you two pay attention? We have a monster to catch.
Gee, don't remind me.
Miss Scary?
But she's no monster.
Well, that depends on how you look at it.
Shazam! That's one scary snore.
Should we wake her?
No, I mean she's much less scary sleeping than she is awake.
Huh, you've got a point there.
That's completely true.
Too true.
Right, everybody back to my house. I'll make some hot cocoa.
Now that's what I'm talking about.
Why not? No use trying to sleep until she stops with that noise.
And so, as evening falls on Dillydale, the tired and weary Mr. Men and Little Misses take to their beds, ready for a good night's sleep.
Good night, Mr. Pernickety.
Good night, Mr. Messy.
Good night, Miss Chatterbox. Good night, Miss Sunshine. Don't let the bedbugs bite. Not that there are any bedbugs in Dillydale. If there were, I wouldn't be able to sleep.
Good night, Mr. Rude.
I'll give you good night.
Mr. Rude!
My apologies.